Hey guys, what's up? Misha, aka Bulb from Periphery here. And today we're with Metal Sucks and we're gonna be watching some Periphery fan covers. I've never done this before, so this is exciting. All right, let's go. And he's using my signature Jackson. It's a beautiful guitar. But this is an 8-string song and he's doing it on a 7, so that's already blasphemy. It's always wrong. All right, and I am just joking because this guy's a phenomenal guitarist, producer, whatever. I already know this is gonna be good. What I love is like, now it really seems like, I don't know if everyone's doing this, but there's like this contingent of cover guys or whatever who really focus on their video production. Like the stuff looks great, you're getting wonderful angles, you're getting like, I don't know if this is like color grading or just a LUT or whatever over it, but it looks great. This guy's actually like extremely talented. Watch out for this guy. I can't tell if I'm hearing like the slightest bit of tuning, and tuning is not something I would ever hold against anyone. Like, this is the way that note transitions, but it doesn't matter. Her tone is incredible, and everyone uses tuning anyways. You could just soften that hard tuning thing there. It could also be her voice. Like, she's got a lot of control, but it's totally overshadowing the acoustic cover part, which is really well done. It sounds great, and I really, really hope that Brad Henge's legal name is Brad Henge. That'll probably be the most disappointing part of my day today, if I find out that that's not his legal name. Okay, so I guess like all these covers are just gonna be absolutely killer. I thought there was gonna be like a range. This is all top. Oh my God, this is killer. This is so good. So I'm not reacting, I'm just like observing and enjoying. This is amazing. Ooh, good harmonies. I like that. We should have done that. Huh? Spencer, we should have done that, huh? Makes our song sound a lot better than it is. This is what happens when like just the top tier of talent reinterprets your song with all of their talent, and then I'm gonna just try and take as much credit for this as possible. He's getting the vocal line there. This drummer's killer, by the way. You know why? Because he's got feel. You hear that, drummers? You want to be able to groove. All the technique in the world is wonderful, but you want to be able to groove. I'm always impressed when like the vocalists can nail the screaming and the singing parts, because that's hard. It took us a very long time to find a vocalist that could do that. You know, covering this stuff is very detail-oriented. Sometimes it can actually seem pretty simple on the surface. Great video quality all around. Getting like four people covering again. Like this is awesome. Vocalist has a very different voice from Spencer, but he's totally making it his own. And he can also sing and scream. So it's just showing you that there's a completely different way to skin that cat. Well done. All right, so this is playing over the existing track, but I can hear your guitar very clearly. This is one of my pet peeves with some covers. Like people do a cover and you cannot hear the part that they're playing, and then you don't know what's what, and it could look really good, but then I know that they're playing parts wrong. She's nailing this. And this is a very complex song. This is a very technical song to play. And this this riff is really funny, because it was a joke. Like, this is just Mark like messing on the guitar. Like, he always plays really dumb riffs to just throw us off when we're like recording or doing anything. But I was like, that's actually really cool. We're gonna record it. So he's got the green screen going. He's got his own character, and he's definitely owning it. He's got confidence. And also getting all the harmonies too. There's a lot of detail work in the harmonies, and Spencer goes nuts with those. Oh, and he's going even more nuts there. The only part I don't know is the green screen clouds, but as far as like talent and the cover and the sound and everything, that is just, yeah, 10 out of 10, crushing it. And this song requires quite a bit of range, because Spencer goes pretty low on this part and then pretty high on some of the choruses. So it's actually a pretty challenging cover to do. This is definitely a cover. It's like a different band. Well done, Metal Sucks. The brown guy sucks at guitar. Do I have to watch this? Yeah, we had Tom Murphy on bass and Alex Boyce on guitar for this, and Travis Orban on drums. Look at me trying to like have stage presence and play. I look very awkward. For 2008, this sounds better than I thought it would. I give us a pretty hard time on old videos, but sound quality is pretty good on this one. It's a good lineup of musicians, though. Ooh, someone fumbled the note there. I'll give this a 4 out of 10. Solid effort, but you'll never be Periphery. That was awesome. Minus that last video, obviously, but like that I am blown away by the level of talent that I'm seeing here. I swear there is just this like quantum leap in average talent as every 5 or 10 years passes. Maybe it's all the YouTube, maybe it's people raising the bar constantly, but I did not know that there was this level of covers out there, you know, in general, let alone for our stuff. We're not even that big a band. Like, I don't understand why people would put this much work into our music, but I am very appreciative of it. This was genuinely a lot of fun to watch. I'm actually excited to see what happens with these people in their careers, because there's some real talent there. There's definitely talent to where that would not be the limiting factor were you to continue on in the music industry. So I wish all these people the best of luck. And maybe some of these guys are successful. I wouldn't even be surprised. But I love it. Keep it coming. And it was a real treat to watch these. So thanks so much for joining me, guys. I'll catch you later.